Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to discuss weak maps. A weak map can be used in such a situation. Suppose I have a weak map that has a key in the form of an object. If such a key in object form is deleted outside the weak map, the key and value corresponding to that object in the weak map are also deleted in a weak map automatically. In this way, we can save memory, which cannot be achieved by an ordinary map. And I'm going to show you this particular feature of weak map by the use of examples. Now, let us see the HTML file first. The HTML file is quite simple. I have a title and a heading. And this HTML file is linked to a JavaScript file called myscript.js, which is stored in the JS folder. Now, let us go to the JS file. In order for me to use the strict mode of JavaScript, I say use strict on the first line of the JavaScript file. And now I'm going to discuss the use of weak maps. Let us see an example without the use of weak maps first. Now you see that I have already created an object called animal. And I'm going to assign this animal object to the key of a certain map called my map. So for ordinary maps, the key of an object will still exist even though I have already deleted the object outside the map declaration. So it's a bit abstract, I think so. So let us see the example now. Now this animal object is already declared, and this animal object becomes the key of a certain set called my map. Okay. So the value of this animal object key is just a string called my dog. Okay. And now I'm going to delete this object called animal outside the map declaration. The way to delete this object is just use the keyword. So in this case, this animal object is already deleted. So the object is gone. And let me show you the object. Now, since it is already deleted, in principle, I can't show the content of the animal object. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see null because this object has become null by this assignment here, okay? But the object assigned to a map and its value will still exist in my map called my map. So the memory is still occupied in my map. So let us see the situation right now. How can I show it? I can just use the for loop. Now, I'm going to show the content of my keys. Since the key is actually an object, I can show the key and value of that particular object. So you can see that even though I have already deleted the animal object, the object content still exists in the map called my map. So let me comment it out and run the program. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that in my map, the keys still exist. So this is the animal type, which is the key of the animal object. And the corresponding value of that key is dog. And for the second key value pair, the key is color, which is obtained by this alert window. And the corresponding value of that key is white, which is shown in the animal object. So even though this object is already deleted outside the map declaration, my map still contains this animal key content, which is not really ideal because the memory is still occupied in my map. So you suppose the animal object is also gone when I delete it outside the map declaration. So is there any way to address this issue? yes, we can use a weak map instead of an ordinary map. In addition to showing the keys, I can also show you the values, and I'm able to tell you that the value still exists in the map. So let us see the result. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see my dog, which is the value corresponding to the animal object which has been removed already. So you can see that both the keys and the values will still exist in my map, even though the entire object key is already removed. So this situation isn't really ideal, because we will still occupy memory in our map for some object that is already gone. So we can address this issue by using a weak map. In a weak map, once the object is already deleted outside the weak map declaration, the assigned object key in the map and its corresponding value is gone. Here I want to say weak map. So in this case, the memory can be saved. So let us see an example. Suppose I've already got a certain object called plant, and in this object I have two key value pairs. And now I'm trying to use this object called plant to create my weak map. So I use the weak map keyword together with the reserved word called new. And now I can insert some content into my weak map. So now I set my object key into the weak map, and the corresponding value to that object key is my tree, which is a string. So the setup is already finished. The weak map has one key value pair, whose key is an object and whose value is a string. And now I can try to get the value of the key right now. You can expect that the value is my tree. Is it the case? Let's see. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see my tree, which serves as the value of that corresponding key called plant, which is an object. And now I'm trying to remove the plant object. I just use the null keyword to remove the plant object from my memory. And let me show the content of the plant after the setup to become null. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see now the content of the plant becomes null. That means this object is gone. And we can check the situation in my weak map. Now I want to see whether the value corresponding to the object key called plant is still present in my weak map. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see the answer becomes undefined. It just means that when the object key is gone, the corresponding value already put in my weak map is also gone. So the entire key value pair in my weak map is gone when the plant object key is gone. So in this case, my weak map has no key value pair because the plant was originally the only key. And when the object is gone, the corresponding value is also gone. So I'm going to show you the disappearance of the corresponding key. I can use the has keyword to see whether that particular key in my weak map exists or not. Save. Reload. Yes, it is false. It just means that the plant object key is already gone in my weak map. So now my current my weak map variable has no key value pairs inside because of the nature of the weak map property here. When the object key is gone, the corresponding value is also gone. That means the whole key value pair in my weak map is also gone. So the video has already discussed the usage of weak maps. It is used to address the memory issue when an ordinary map has lost its key, which is in object form outside the map declaration. So in this case, when I use the weak map, and when the object key is gone, the corresponding key and value pair in the weak map are also gone. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.